So welcome to A-Level Biology. I'll be talking you through the general structure of the course, including what you'll be studying, any trips we go on, how you'll be assessed, entry requirements, and where studying biology can take you after college. So if you've excelled in studying biology at GCSE and have a strong interest in knowing more about the core topics you've studied, such as cell biology, anatomy, energy transfer, genetics and ecology, then A-Level Biology is the right course for you. You'll work through these topics during your first 2 years of studying, plus some new topics such as biochemistry and gene technology. So a general class size in biology is no larger than 25 students. As a science student, you'll spend the majority of your lesson time up in the science hub on the fourth floor. As with your other subjects, you'll have 5.5 hours of biology lesson time per week, which is divided up into 2 2-hour sessions and 1 1.5 hour session. Outside of class, you're expected to put in the same amount of hours into independent study. In biology, we work by setting pre-reading material for our students to complete a task prior to the lesson so that you'll be able to come to the lesson with a basic understanding of the lesson objectives for your tutor to build on and reinforce with application tasks such as quizzes, group work and exam questions. What will I study? The first year topics are as follows. So we start off with biological molecules, looking at carbohydrates, proteins, DNA, lipids and water. We then move on to the cells topic, where we look at the ultrastructure of various cells, the structure and roles of organelles, we look at how we study cells, mitosis, pathogens and the immune system. We then move on to exchange, looking at gas exchange in various organisms, mass transport in animals and plants, before moving on to genetic variation and relationships, looking at protein synthesis, biodiversity, classification, meiosis, and the effect of farming on biodiversity. So the second year topics will start off with energy transfer, where we'll look at photosynthesis and respiration, along with energy transfer in ecosystems and nutrient cycles. We then move on to look at genetic inheritance, so we'll look at both monohybrid and dihybrid inheritance, epistasis, sex-linked inheritance, autosomal gene linkage, Hardy-Weinberg, population genetics, sampling of population of plants and animals, before we move on to the control of gene expression and genetic technologies. So we'll look at transcription factors, small interfering RNA and microRNA, epigenetics, cancer, genetic modification, screening for genetic diseases and gene therapy. We then move on to look at response to internal and external environments. So we'll look at simple plant and animal responses. We'll move on to homeostasis, looking at the pancreas, kidney, the heart and the lungs, receptors and the nervous system and synapses, and finally muscles and the sliding filament theory. You will also complete at least 12 practicals as outlined in the practical skills endorsement. However, we strongly believe that practicals are the best part of biology, so you will complete roughly 20 practical sessions over the 2 year qualification. Will I go on any trips? So at the end of your first year of study, you will go on a field trip to the course to study the effect of an environmental variable on the distribution or growth of a specific species. We often visit the zoo, local universities and other colleges, as well as taking part in biology competitions such as the National UK Competition and the Ed Hill University Olympiad. Other trips may be planned throughout the year. Input from students will influence these trips. How will I be assessed? Throughout the year, you'll be assessed by a tutor. This will be done through internal exams called formals. This is to allow you and your tutor to find out where your strengths and areas for development are so they can support you to achieve your potential. Your ability to carry out experiments properly and safely will be assessed during practical sessions. Your experiment reports will also be assessed against a set of common practical assessment criteria. So at the end of your first year of study, you will be required to undertake 2 biology exams. These exams will test you on any of your first year content. They take 1.5 hours. They do not count towards your UCAS points or your second year grade. However, it is used to predict your final grade for university applications. At the end of year 2, you'll sit 3 biology exams. Paper 1 will test on any topics from year 1, paper 2, any topics from year 2, and paper 3, any topics from both years combined. There will also be an essay at the end of paper 3. Each exam from year 2 is 2 hours long. Your practical skills endorsement will be completed before exams start. The practical endorsement is a key element of this qualification, as it's needed to progress onto any science degree. What are the entry requirements? If you study combined or dual science, you must achieve a minimum of 2 grade 6s in a science, a 5 in English language, a 5 in maths. You must also have at least 1 other GCSE at grade 5 or above. If you study single or separate science, you must achieve at least a grade 6 in biology, a grade 5 in English language and a grade 5 in maths. You must also have at least two other GCSE subjects at a grade 5 or above. Where could this subject lead? So where could biology lead you? Biology can lead you literally anywhere. Biology is classed as a facilitating subject by universities. This means the course has a multitude of transferable skills that can be applied to many other subject areas. The majority of biology students continue on to higher education, with most making use of their biological knowledge. We have had students go on to study more traditional biology related courses, such as medicine, dentistry, pharmacy, or straight biology. Within biology, there are also thousands of other specialisms, such as microbiology, zoology, neuroscience, bioinformatics, biochemistry, and marine biology, to name just a few. We also have students who have used their biology to gain entry into other higher education courses, including psychology, sociology, law, English, ancient history of Italian, and computing. So if biology sounds like the course for you, please get in contact and ask us any questions that you have, or if you'd like to know more about the course or the details that I've discussed in this video, view the Burnley College Prospectus online.